All right, so Tanaka roughed up yesterday, 10 hits and 5 and a third. Here are his stats, his past 7 starts. And I realized that one of those starts was in London against the Red Sox, which might have exaggerated it just a bit because that was arena baseball out there in London, that 2-game series with the Red Sox. I don't know if you saw the stat, Peter. Tanaka has allowed 48 hits and 36 runs in 30 and two-thirds innings. That's an earned run average of 10.23. Not great.
No.
But he's probably the game one starter, right? If Severino doesn't come back or comes back but isn't effective, because even though Brian Cashman said he has confidence, he signed him to a contract, there's still the Severino from the last half of 2018 that have people nervous. Take Severino out of it, the conversation right now. Of the 5 starters they have, Tanaka's still the guy you would go with in game one.
Yeah, I don't know. Well, what would your other option be?
Well, I mean, Paxton's never pitched in the postseason. He hasn't been great. Well, look at it. Here we go. Herman has a 5.55 earned run average his last 9 starts. Paxton has a 4.61 and has pitched fewer than 5 innings in 8 of his 19 starts. Sabathia is on the IL, but he's allowed 2.4 homers per 9 innings. Only one other Yankee pitcher in history to pitch at least 100 innings has allowed 2.0 home runs per 9. And then there's Jay Happ this season. Hasn't been terrific either. So Tanaka is still going to probably be your guy. From Happ, mm-hmm. Paxton, Herman, CeCe, who's hurt right now. So, hey, I talked a lot yesterday about how Yankee fans should be very happy. This team is one of the best teams in baseball. This team is going to run away with the division. But if you want to get a little nitpicky, is you got to get Tanaka turned around. I mean, he, I think, is your best potential game one starter. If you don't have you got to have somebody to pitch well. You didn't pick up anybody at the deadline. One of these pitchers, if not two, if not all, have to be better. So that's the one thing to kind of keep an eye on. Because I do think offense is probably more of a player in the postseason than it's been back in the day. I do kind of cringe when I hear pitching wins championships, defense wins championships. I get that, but you also have to score some runs. I don't think the Yankees can win a lot of 14-12 games in the postseason consistently. You'd like to get some starting pitching. These guys have to step it up and be better. I mean, the Orioles stink. Now, they can hit in a ballpark like Camden Yards, but come on. I mean, 10 hits and 5 and a third innings against a team that just can't wait to play golf? I mean, let's turn it around here. So you're looking for something, some relevancy to the Yankees the rest of the regular season? Get healthy if you can. Try to get Stanton back, but for the most part, get at least a couple of pitchers pitching better.